It is my assertion in this presentation that America is under judgment.
Confess! Me bone!
Well, it's zigger, crack, then dry bones. It's zigger, crack, then dry bones. It's zigger, crack, then dry bones. Now hear the word of the Lord.
You unlock this door with the key of imagination. Beyond it is another dimension, a dimension of mind. You've just crossed over into...
A great delusion, a great lie has crept across this nation and has had evil consequences. Generations of our kids are being taught in our public education system, in the secular universities, that we're just animals. We're just animals that evolved from ape-like creatures. We're no different to the animals. President Obama, speaking in Turkey to the President of Turkey, April 6, 2009, said this.
We do not consider ourselves a Christian nation or a Jewish nation or a Muslim nation. We consider ourselves a nation of citizens who are bound by ideals and a set of values.
Who determines those values? Who determines what's right?
Jane, you ignorant slut.
When you abandon a foundation in the absolute authority of the Word of God and you build your thinking on man's word, the definition of everything is plastic.
Well, I'm afraid he'll have to go. His magnet turned my radio.
A sign that God is withdrawing the restraining influence of the Holy Spirit is that sign of homosexual behavior, gay marriage that is permeating this nation. You know, on Fox News, Mike Huckabee made a very strong stand, actually.
We have operated under the principle of judicial review since the Marbury versus Madison case in 1803.
Chris, the Supreme Court is not the supreme branch, and for God's sake, it isn't the supreme being.
There's a sexual perversion war brewing in the USA, and it's going to get ugly. But for those who know God and His Word, our duty is clear.
Most of the founding fathers started with the Word of God, an absolute authority who determined right and wrong.
Like a mighty army moves the Church of God. Christians, we are treading where the saints have trod. We are not divided, all one body.
We are losing this culture before our very eyes right now. So what's the solution? We help people understand that history in Genesis concerning creation of a perfect world, the entrance of sin and death, corruption because of man's rebellion against God, the catastrophe of Noah's flood and the Tower of Babel, that history is true. Ultimately, every single biblical doctrine is founded in Genesis 1 to 11. They're all founded in Genesis. The whole gospel message is founded in Genesis. And we have researchers.
Files were ransacked for the names and records of every clod, pole, dim bulb, and schnook in the country.
To help people understand that we can go out and in biology and geology and astronomy and chemistry and so on, and we can show how the evidence confirms over and over again the Bible's history. We better go and tell the President of the United States and the Vice President and all the Senators and the Congressmen, right?
Hip, hip, hooray!
And hear the word of the Lord.
Guilty!